guys, let's all shout. Warm, cold,
cold, warm,
try to find the acorn. Yeah! Look around, look around, till the acorn has been found. Warm, cold,
cold, warm,
time to find the acorn. Time to find the acorn.
Do you want to play Find the Acorn?
Yes!
This is the backyard. Where should I hide the acorn? Maybe I'll put it under this tree. No. How about behind this sprinkler? Nah. Oh, I know. I'll put it in the doghouse. Okay, Eve, come and find the acorn. Okay, you know how to play. When I say warm, that means you're getting close to the acorn. When I say cold, it means you're far away. And when I clap, that means you're right next to it. Hey, let's practice. Let's all clap together. Ready? Clap! Good job! Remember to clap just like that when Eve is right next to the acorn, okay? Great!
Is it here?
You're cold.
Am I close?
Brr, still cold. Getting warmer? Warmer? Let's tell Eve that she's right next to the acorn. Remember how? Right! Clap your hands!
Yes!
We found the acorn, we found it over here. We found the acorn after looking everywhere. We found it, so let's all clap and cheer.
It's my turn to hide the acorn. Sammy, close your eyes. I'll put the acorn under the tree. Cold. Cold? Still cold. Keep looking. No, the acorn isn't over there. Getting warmer. Let Sammy know that he's near the acorn. Clap your hands.
We found the acorn. We found it over here. We found the acorn after looking at cheer. Yahoo!
The game is over. That was so much fun.
Thanks for helping.
Bye.
Listen to the sounds as they fill the air. Bonnie's magic brush will take us there. Dear Bonnie Bear, let's all play the listening game every day. Listen to the sounds as they fill the air. Pictures come alive, can you see them there? Oh dear Bonnie Bear, let's all play the listening game. Listen to the sounds. Listen to the sounds and play.
Bonnie Bear.
Hello, hello. My name
Hello, Bonnie. Do you want to play the listening game?
Mm-hmm. I do. My magic paintbrush is ready, too.
Okay, then. Let's play. Did you hear that sound? Let's listen to it again. What could it be, Bonnie?
That sounds like popcorn popping.
That's right, a popcorn machine making popcorn. Okay, now I'm going to play another sound for you. Ooh, did you hear that? Let's listen to it again. What could it be?
I know. Somebody eating popcorn.
Somebody eating popcorn. That's right, Bonnie. Okay, now I'm going to play another sound. Get ready. Did you hear that sound? Let's listen to it again. So, what could it be?
I think I know. It's a boy laughing.
A boy laughing. That's right. Bonnie, let's listen to the sounds again.
Popcorn popping. Somebody eating popcorn. A boy laughing.
So, Bonnie, can you guess where you can hear those sounds?
I can. Whee! Those are sounds from a movie theater.
That's right, Bonnie. A movie theater.
Thank you. step into the acorn. He's taking the broom to Eddie's room, 11 pennies.
Picture a tunnel, one that's full of so much light, laughs, and fun that you just wouldn't want to come out. Sounds like a dream, doesn't it? Well, wake up, because that dream is real. And it's here on Baby First TV's newest series, Magic Tunnels, where every tunnel is a doorway to a different kind of world of learning and fun. Classic puzzles will engage and challenge you. Beautiful objects will disassemble and reassemble. Hilarious surprises will hatch out of special eggs. Groovy Newton's cradle toys of all designs to play with. A most extraordinary shape-shifting friend, and lots more. So dig into Magic Tunnels, where little ones are sure to enjoy a magical multi-sensory adventure. Magic Tunnels, starting October 6th, only on Baby First TV.
Make it do whatever step out. But it works, make it help. That boom.
Ich bin mal begeistert, begeistert. shape. And green takes me back to my favorite shape. Red is for strawberries and big reindeer noses. Yellow for sunshine and even some roses. I love all colors, I think they're the best. So come join us all in our big color fest.
Petey the Paintbrush!
Hi, I'm Petey the Paintbrush. I love to paint using all different colors, like red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and purple.
What's your favorite color, Petey?
A favorite? I don't have just one favorite color. I love them all. I choose colors by what I feel like painting that day.
What do you want to paint today?
Today, I feel like painting a baby bottle. What color should I use to paint a baby bottle? Blue!
Blue!
Today I'm going to paint with blue. And I'm going to start by painting a baby bottle. Uh-oh, someone needs that blue baby bottle. What else can I paint with blue? I know. A pretty blue feather. Feathers tickle. I can use blue to paint an airplane too. Watch this. Go, blue airplane, go! You know what else you can paint with the color blue? Beautiful blue eyes. Blue eyes are pretty. Today, I painted with blue. I made a blue baby bottle. A blue feather that tickles. A flying blue airplane. And beautiful blue eyes. I bet you can find something blue to paint today too. I love color. Oh yes, I do. I love them all. Do you love colors too? Bye-bye!
Same way. That's because they're brother and sister.
Mm-hmm.
That means that they have the same mommy and daddy.
Mm-hmm.
Dottie is older than Dot.
Uh-huh.
Dottie is Dot's big sister.
Mm-hmm.
He loves Dottie very much. She taught him how to bark.
Woof, 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 woof. Woof, 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 woof.
Mm-hmm. And how to catch a ball.
Mm-hmm.
Dot thinks she's the best sister in the world.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Do you have a big sister? If you do, bring her next time. I would love to meet her.
Into a house that's made of magic balloons, where we all play games and whistle happy tunes. This is Bobby's house, it's a special wonderland. His hands create the magic, your wish is his command.
Fiona.
Hi, Fred. Fred, what do you feel like doing today?
Let's have Bordy draw a penguin for us today.
That's a great idea. Let's go to Bordy the Board.
To the board.
To the board. To the magical Bordy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Imagination comes alive.
Hello, Fred and Fiona. What would you like me to draw today?
I have an idea. Bordy, can you draw a penguin?
That's not a penguin. A penguin is an animal. That's a kite.
Well, that's not a penguin either. That's a whale.
How do you know?
Because penguins are smaller and they have feet.
Feet, huh? I think we can get a penguin. Are you ready, Fred?
I'm ready.
One, two, three, go!
A penguin!
Oh, what joy! Oh, what a sight! We were together and got it right! Whee!
Hey, Fiona, what's wrong? You look sad.
This is a nice penguin, but it's all by itself. I want to see where penguins live.
Wait, I know.
A penguin in a tree? Penguins don't live in trees.
A penguin in a box? That's not right.
I think we can get it right this time. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
One, two, three, go!
Oh, what joy! Oh, what a sight! We were together and got it right!
Oh no! The penguin is gone!
That's okay. Bordy can help us find the penguin again.
First, we saw a penguin in a tree. But that's not right. Penguins don't live in trees. They can't even fly.
Then we saw a penguin in a box. But that isn't right either.
That's funny.
But we finally got it right. Penguins live in cold places. They live on land, but spend a lot of their time in the water. Very good, Fiona.
Thank you, Fred. Not too bad yourself.
Goodbye, Fred and Fiona. See you next time.
The information provided in this program is for informational purposes only. Please consult with your physician.
Pexseed, what are you doing with those pebbles?
Daddy penguins collect pebbles to use to build their nests.
But, Frog, you're not a daddy.
I know, but I just like collecting pebbles.
Are you a pebble collector?
I have a lot of very beautiful pebbles, but I don't have any pebbles from the desert yet.
I know what I'll do. I'll get you a pebble from the desert for your birthday.
Thank you, Pexseed. Good luck.
Ow! Ow! The sand is hot on my feet! Oh, there's no tree for me to rest on. I'm not happy here.
I'm hot and thirsty. I'm tired and my feet hurt. And there's nobody to talk to. Hey! Hey, wait for me!
Yes, who are you? And what do you want?
I'm Peckseed. I'm lost and alone. And all I want to do is rest on a tree and drink some water.
You silly little bird. This is the desert. You won't find that here. Goodbye.
Oh, that wasn't very friendly. Doesn't anyone else live in this place? Oh, you scared me.
Who are you, little bird?
I'm Peckseed. I'm lost and alone, and all I want to do is to rest on a tree and drink some water.
You silly little bird. This is a desert. You won't find any of those things here. Goodbye, little bird.
Is there no one who can help me? Aha! Water! Now I can get a drink and rest, and then I will return home. What's going on? I thought I saw some water all around an island.
I'm not an island. I'm a camel, you funny bird. Camels live in deserts.
Tell me, what is a camel? Huh?
Camels are very pretty animals with two big humps on their backs.
What are the humps for on your back?
The humps are for little birds that have lost their way in the desert to rest on.
But how did you know I'm lost? Are camels magical animals?
No, no. I know you are lost because the snake and the spider told me. I'm here to help you.
That's so strange. I met the snake and the spider, and they didn't like me even one little bit.
The snake and the spider do like you. They just couldn't help you. But I can. Come with me. I'll help you find your way.
Almost there yet?
We're here.
Where are we? I only see sand. And
are you sure, little bird? Keep looking. Capuchiki, Capuchika, are you here, scorpion?
Hi, how can I help you?
This little bird is very hungry. She wants to eat.
Easy. Capuchika, Capuchiko, Capuchiko. There you go.
Oh, great. Yes. Yum, yum. That was really good. Thank you. I'm going home now and tell my friends about my new friends in the desert.
Good. Come back and see me soon, little bird.
Yes. Come back and visit us soon.
Do you have my pebble?
Oh, no. I forgot to get a pebble. And I think I've got a cold. Achoo! Achoo!
Look, Peckseed, there's sand coming from your wings.
And the sand is made of little pebbles. Oh, look, aren't they cute?
That's the nicest birthday present I've ever had.
We have play dates. I love playing games with my friends.
Sometimes I even play jokes on them.
What's that?
It's not coming from in there. The knocking isn't coming from here either. I wonder what that knocking could be. Aha! I know! It's a visitor knocking at the door! Oh me, oh my! I wonder who's come by! Who goes there? Whoa! That's one big sound! Somebody's come over for a play date. But I can't tell who it is. Can you help me figure it out? Who is it? Let's listen. What animal sounds like that? Ah! It sounds like barking!
Ruff, 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 ruff!
I know what animals bark. Dogs! Dogs love to bark! It must be my friend Donnelly the dog at the door! To visit the one and only Tilly. That's me.
Why, yes, Tilly. I've come over to play. Can I come in?
That bark is definitely a dog.
Hi, Tilly. It's nice to see you.
I knew that had to be you, Donnelly. A big bark from a big dog.
We dogs love to bark.
We figured it out. A big bark from a big dog. I'm glad you came over to play with me. Come by again. You never know who will visit next time.
Bye-bye.
See Sally, Mally, and her little cat Jack. If you hear squawking when you're out walking, it must be Sally, Mally, and her little cat Jack. Sally's house is full of laughter. Jack needs some looking after. Isn't that what friends are for? So come see Sally, Mally, and her
There was something going on in Sally Mally's garden. What was that? It was Jack. He was making a tent with an old sheet. A very old sheet. Sally Mally thought that Jack's tent was great. Jack was quite pleased with his little tent. Yoo-hoo! Called a voice. It was Sally Mally. She'd brought Jack some lunch. Said Jack, gratefully as he began to eat. Sally Mally thought that Jack was a clever little bird. He'd made the tent all by himself. Oh dear. Ah! Sally Mally thought that Jack looked very funny. Poor Jack. He was very disappointed. Never mind, Jack, said Sally Mally. I'm going to the store. I'll bring you a present. Jack was very excited. Sally set off for the store. Bye-bye, Jack, she said. Said Jack, hoping she'd be back soon. Jack waited and waited. Sally Mally had been gone a long time. Then suddenly he saw her. Sally Mally was coming home. Jack couldn't wait to see his present. Hello, Jack, said Sally Mally. Look what I got for you. Said Jack. It was a tent. A real tent. All they had to do was put it up. At last the tent was ready. Jack and Sally Mally were going to sleep in the tent that night. Sally Mally and Jack settled down to sleep right away. Good night, Jack, said Sally Mally. Said Jack. Jack couldn't sleep. But Sally Mally was already fast asleep. Then Jack heard a noise. He said, shh, Jack, mumbled Sally Mally. It's only a hedgehog. Then Jack heard another noise. Said Jack. He was a bit scared. Shh, Jack, mumbled Sally Mally. It's only a rabbit. Then Jack heard another noise. It was an owl hooting. Cried Jack. This time he was really scared. Sally Mally had had enough. Come along, Jack, said Sally Mally. We're going back inside. At last, Sally Mally and Jack were safe in bed. What an eventful day it had been. Good night, Jack, said Sally Mally.
Roar,
said Jack.
Mr. Bad. see Mr. Backpipes. Listen to our loud music! That's loud music!
Now let's play our music softly! Soft music.
Springtime on Family Farm. The flowers are opening, the trees are budding, and the birds are singing. But Tech looks very unhappy.
What's the matter with you? Have your tires gone flat?
Asked Cluck. No, said Tech.
Then why are you so unhappy?
Asked Hannah. Because I've got nothing to do, answered Tech.
Come with me to look for some worms, suggested Cluck.
No, thank you, said Tech. That very second, Molly, Katie's mom, came rushing out of the house. Tech, hurry, she called. We're going to Greenfield Farm. Greenfield Farm? Wonderful! Tech gave a big smile. But why was Molly going to Greenfield Farm in such a hurry? Come on! Jane hurt her arm and needs help in the cafe. In no time at all, Molly and Tech were on their way to Greenfield Farm. Tech had never been to Greenfield Farm before, but he had heard Katie talking about the donkeys, goats, rabbits, and pheasants that live there. And even, what was the name of the strange bird again? Here we are. We've arrived. Beep, beep. Tix sounded his horn. At the farm, Molly got straight to work. She picked up a bowl full of eggs that had been left on the ledge. But oh no! The bowl slipped from her hands and all the eggs smashed to bits on the ground. Oh dear, what a waste! Exclaimed Molly. Don't worry, I'll go find some more eggs, said Tech. Thank you, Tech, said Molly. But don't be long, okay? I won't, said the little red tractor. And he hurried across the farmyard. He hadn't gone very far when he suddenly stopped. He had no idea where he was going. Whose eggs was he supposed to be collecting? The duck's eggs? The hen's eggs? The cockatoo's eggs? The parrot's eggs? Oh well, he'd just have to decide for himself. Molly was doing very well in the cafe. What can I get you? She asked the man by the window. Two fried eggs, please, asked the man pleasantly. Oh dear, thought Molly. Where is Tech with those eggs? The eggs! The eggs! Oh dear! Said Tech as he drove on. When he saw some donkeys in a field, he sped over to them and said, Hello, I'm Tech, the little red tractor.
Yes, said Desmond the donkey.
Well, do you have any eggs?
Hee-haw, hee-haw, eggs, laughed Beryl. Of course not. We cannot lay eggs, she said.
Oh, no, said Tech.
That's right. We can't, agreed Desmond. Birds lay eggs, said Beryl.
And reptiles, said Desmond.
What are reptiles? Asked Tech. Snakes, crocodiles, oh, and frogs. They lay eggs too, said Desmond.
Desmond the donkey was quite a smart guy.
All right, said Tech, and he drove off.
Ducks, donkeys, pigs, and goats. Galloping gaskets. When was he going to find some animals that lay eggs?
There you are. Cheese on toast and a cup of tea, said Molly to one customer. But the other was still waiting for his eggs and looking at his watch.
I'm so sorry for the delay.
Where were those eggs?
As Tech passed the sheds, he saw some hens pecking and scratching. He had found hens.
Excuse me, said Tech.
Wriggling worms, what do you want?
Asked the rooster.
The cafe needs eggs in a hurry. Have you laid any this morning?
Of course we have, they all clucked.
Just tell me where they are, and I will collect them.
But the hens weren't paying attention to Tech. They were too busy scratching for food.
Oh, Oh, please, tell me where the eggs are, asked Tech.
Hey, Sonny, don't waste your time with them, snorted the pig. They won't tell you anything. They're a bunch of snooty hens, and they've had their beaks in the air since they arrived here, if you know what I mean. Do you know where the eggs are? Asked Tech. No, sorry.
Galloping gaskets, sighed Tech before driving away impatiently. What was he to do? They were still waiting for the eggs in the cafe. Any moment now, he is on his way, honestly, said Molly. But the man didn't look happy at all.
Look at him! Crying! Spitting feathers! Ha-ha!
Teased Kathy Cockatoo.
Spitting feathers? Asked Tech.
Certainly not. The hens may not have been very helpful, but he hadn't eaten any of them, and he didn't have any feathers in his mouth.
Ha-ha! Yes, spitting feathers! It means you are angry! You're upset because you haven't found any eggs!
And I've looked everywhere, said Tech.
Ha! Ha! I know, I know! I know where you can find eggs!
Where? Where? Asked Tech.
Not telling! Not telling! Ha! Ha!
Laughed Kathy Cockatoo.
Oh, please! Begged Tech.
Yes, go on. Tell him, said Fanny Pheasant.
Yes, all right. Yes, all right. I'll tell. I'll tell. They're in the pond! They're in the pond! There! Said Kathy.
In the pond? Asked Tech.
What a strange place to find eggs. He had never heard of a hen laying eggs in a pond before.
There are one, two, three! One, two, three! A bucketful! A whole bucketful!
Called Kathy.
But how will I get them out of the pond?
Ask the carpenter. He'll help you,
said Kathy.
Okay,
said Tech happily, and he set off right away. He didn't have much time left. As luck would have it, the carpenter's workshop door was open, and he came out just as Tech arrived.
Can you help me get eggs out of the pond?
Tech asked.
I certainly can, answered the carpenter.
I'm really in a bit of a hurry, you see, said Tech breathlessly.
The carpenter searched around for the eggs.
Do you see any eggs? Asked Tech.
Yes, answered the carpenter. Here.
The carpenter rolled up his sleeves, got down on his knees, and reached into the pond.
What's he doing? I can't see, said Tech.
Then the carpenter straightened up, holding a tub with a tightly shut lid.
Oh, thank you so much, said Tech. And off he went.
Remember to drive carefully now, said the carpenter.
Thanks,
shouted Tech.
Bye,
said the carpenter. Finally, Tech drove to the cafe with the eggs safely in the tub. But just as Tech arrived, the customer who wanted eggs was leaving.
Wait, said Molly. Here come the eggs.
They've arrived! Straight from the nest! Completely fresh! The man paused.
Eggs? Eggs? Those are frogs' eggs! Squeaked the man, before hurrying off to his car.
Oh, Tech! Exclaimed Molly. I wanted hen's eggs, not frog's eggs.
That Kathy cockatoo! Roared Tech.
Kathy cockatoo could be heard laughing from far away. Tricky old bird.
My Jamie colicky.
When is a good time for Emily to give up her comfort object?
What do I do when my Claire has a bad dream? The parenting tip of the day. Baby First TV's newest offering to you, the parent, sets out to answer as many of those unanswerable questions that arise daily when raising children. Developed under the supervision of leading child development experts, each parenting tip of the day aims to offer you, the parent, tools to deal with the most pressing of your child's issues and questions in a manner that would best serve you and your baby. Raising our children is a joy, but even when the going gets tough, we at Baby First TV will still be there for you, lending a helping hand and offering a helpful tip. Parenting tip of the day, every day, only on Baby First TV.
If I were a tiger, I would prowl through the jungle. I would prowl through the jungle, then I'd prowl some more.
Roar, tiger, roar! Roar, tiger, roar!
And if I were a tiger, I would growl in the jungle. I would growl in the jungle, then I'd growl some more.
Roar, tiger, roar! Roar, tiger, roar!
And if I were a tiger, I would leap in the jungle. I would leap in the jungle, then I'd leap some more.
Roar, tiger, roar! Roar, tiger, roar!
And if I were a tiger, I would sleep in the jungle. I would sleep in the jungle, then I'd sleep some more.
Snore, tiger, snore. Snore, tiger, snore.
If I were a tiger, I would prowl through the jungle. I would prowl through the jungle, then I'd prowl some more.
Roar, tiger, roar! Roar, tiger, roar!
And if I was a tiger, I would growl in the jungle. I would growl in the jungle, then I'd growl some more.
Roar, tiger, roar! Roar, tiger, roar!
And if I was a tiger, I would leap in the jungle. I would leap in the jungle, then I'd leap some more.
Roar, tiger, roar!
I would sleep in the jungle. I would sleep in the jungle, then I'd sleep some more.
Snore, tiger, snore.
Snore, snore, tiger, snore.
10 rubber duckies. There are 10 on the tub, and the blue one says, "Move over, move over." So they all move over. And one falls in. There are 9 on the tub, and the blue one says, "Move over, move over." So they all move over. And one dives in. There are 8 on the tub, and the blue one says, "Move over, move over." So they all move over. And one jumps in. There are 7 on the tub. And the blue one says, "Move over, move over." So they all move over. And one flies in. There are six on the tub, and the blue one says, "Move over, move over." So they all move over. And one plops in. There are five on the tub, and the blue one says, "Move over, move over." So they all move over. And one flops in. There are four on the tub, and the blue one says, "Move over, move over." So they all move over. And one hops in. There are three on the tub, and the blue one says, "Move over, move over." So they all move over. And one falls in. There are two on the tub, and the blue one says, "Move over, move over." So they all move over. And one slides in. There's one on the tub, and the blue one says, "Let's swim."
You did it! You put it together. One, two, three. What does it make? Can you see?
Pig!
Yep. It's a pig.
Phew.
Good job. I love puzzles. I hope you had fun doing a puzzle, too. Toodle-doo.
Want to see?
Sure.
Okay.
Watch this. Ta-da!
I'm not sure I get it, Peanut. What's the trick?
Okay, Yo-Yo. Watch again. Closely this time, okay?
Okay, I'm watching.
Front?
Mm-hmm.
Whoop. Back?
Mm-hmm.
Ta-da!
Back.
Front?
Front. That's great, Peanut! I want to try. Front.
Front?
Back.
Back.
Front. Back. We may never... Oops. We have to turn around again. We may never be the same.
But we love the opposite game.
Give our bunny four teeth. One tooth. Two teeth. Three teeth. Whoa, look at the bunny's pretty smile. Let's count how many teeth he has so far. One, two, three. Three teeth. And... one more. That makes four. Yay! We did it! This is the biggest smile I've ever drawn. How many teeth does the bunny painting have? One, two, three, four. Four for the four teeth. Four for the four teeth. I love the number four. Say bye-bye, Hurry the Bunny. Bye-bye, Funny Bunnies.
Thank you.
Schöne Pipi-Kanten.
Thank you.
Peek-a-boo.
Motion. Thank you.
may seem a perfect match, but look a little closer, you'll find that there's a catch. When one thing just stands out and three things look the same, we have to point it out and call it by its name. What's different? What's different? I found it.
What's different?
We're going to look at four pictures. Three will be the same, but one will be different. Let's look. It's an orange triangle. An orange triangle. What's next? Another orange triangle. That's an orange triangle too. One more. Let's see it. That's a triangle too. Is it orange? We have four triangles, but they are not all the same. Can you spot what's different? Is this triangle different? No. This one's orange, like most of the others. How about this one? This one is orange too. This one matches the other orange triangles. So what's different? This one is different. This one is green. These are orange triangles. The green triangle is different. Good eye. You can spot what's different. Bye-bye.
Bicycle. Flor.
Una flor anaranjada creció en el campo.
Flor.
¡La hora de contar! ¡Contemos teléfonos móviles! Un teléfono móvil. Dos teléfonos móviles. Tres teléfonos móviles. Cuatro teléfonos móviles. Cinco teléfonos móviles. Seis teléfonos móviles. Siete teléfonos móviles. Ocho teléfonos móviles. Nueve teléfonos móviles. ¡Contemos otra vez! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. ¡9 teléfonos móviles! ¡Eso es! ¡Contaron muy bien! ¡Nos vemos pronto en La Hora de Contar!
La palabra del día.
Word of the day.
Beso.
Kiss.
Sol. Hola, Luna. Hola a todos. Mira, todas las piezas abandonaron el tablero. Vamos a ver si puedes colocarlas en la posición correcta. ¿Puedes colocar los binóculos en su lugar? No, no. Prueba otra vez. Lo harás mejor. ¡Perfecto! Es el lugar correcto. Ahora vamos a ver si puedes colocar la lupa. ¡Lo lograste otra vez!